Not everybody can be a robot polisher.
This world is not what you think it is. This world is not what you think it is. Oh,
oh. The sharing of biased and false news has become all too common on social media. More alarming, some media outlets publish these same fake stories without checking facts first.
The sharing of biased and false news
has become all too common on social media. More alarming, some media
we're in this mess. Forever you will acquiesce. How do you love to be deceived? Whatever they tell you, you believe. Dead of sight, dead of mind. News believer, you are blind. Thinker, you are not. Never independent thought. Bust into your paradigm. Hypnotized with pantomime. Regurgitating all you hear. Spread your terror, spread your fear.
Your mind to be free. Never your eyes will ever see. Lick the boot of tyranny. Begging for your slavery. They who have remote control. Let's know your very soul. Turn into the great deceiver. Television watching news believer.
Inject your poison, wear your mask. All they have to do is ask. Never questioning authority. Blindly following like sheep. Yes sir, no sir, three backs full. You television watching fool.
Never your mind to be free. Never your eyes will ever see. Lick the boot of tyranny. Begging for your slavery. They who have remote control. Let's know your very soul. Turn into the great deceiver. Television watching news believer.
Watching news believer.
Never your mind to be free. Never your eyes will ever see.
dangerous to our democracy.
This is extremely dangerous to our democracy.
This is extremely dangerous to our democracy.
This is extremely dangerous to our democracy.
The art of deception.
Today we're going to be talking to you about magic, war, and intelligence.
Magic is an amazing way of thinking.
Yes, magic. Magic is being used by spy agencies, military agencies across the world of governments, and now corporations. Magic is the new science.
Magic is a universal language.
We're talking about social engineering, the clever manipulation of the natural human tendency to trust.
Deception in warfare goes back to early history. By the 19th and 20th century, it became more sophisticated as magicians such as George Méliès began to apply the methods from stage magic to the new medium of motion pictures, thereby pioneering special effects. As the movie industry grew and technology improved, these effects became more convincing. By World War II, these deceptions that had been used to entertain audiences were being used on a larger scale
to defeat the enemy.
This intersection between magic, special effects, military, and intelligence is fascinating.
Not everybody can be a robot polisher.
The important thing you need to know is that you don't know shit. What you see, what you hear, nothing is what it seems.
Space is tough, especially whenever you're trying to show video from space.
When you're designing magic for TV, you want everything to be burnable. Burnable means the audience can continue to watch it with unblinking eyes, even rewind the footage, and still not understand how the deception works.
If you're looking for a launch site anywhere in the world, the ideal location is an island in the middle of the ocean.
What's a Kansas City shuffle?
Kansas City shuffle is when everybody looks right, you go left.
I love misdirection. Misdirection, and simply put, is having something really great to look at over here and hiding something over here that you want to hide.
Never heard of it. That's something people hear about.
The best type of magic uses combinations of methods layered on top of each other. Makes it much more difficult to deconstruct a trick and figure it out.
He's gonna show you the bricks. He'll show you they got straight sides. He'll show you how they got the right shape. He'll show them to you in a very special way so that they appear to have everything a brick should have. But there's one thing he's not going to show you. When you look at the bricks at the right angle, they're as thin as this playing card. It's an illusion, a magic trick.
According to Sam Sharp in Neo Magic, which was published in 1931, there's five different types of effects. There's a vanish. A vanish, something disappears.
3, 2, 1. Boosters in ignition. And liftoff of Artemis 1. We rise together back to the moon and beyond.
He conjures a cloud of smoke, a flash. She's gone. But where did she go?
They get out and head down this tube.
Located 12 meters below the launch pad is a place called the rubber room.
Via that 200-foot escape tube.
He was using technology, basically, to perform a magic trick, which is not uncommon. Technology and magic have gone forward through history together.
There's a production. The production, something appears.
Orion slammed into the Earth's atmosphere at 25,000 miles per hour. The heat shield had to hold up against temperatures of 5,000 degrees, half as hot as the surface of the sun.
If you tell a lie big enough and keep repeating it, people will eventually come to believe it. The lie can be maintained only for such time as the state can shield the people from the political, economic, and/or military consequences of the lie. It thus becomes vitally important for the state to use all of its powers to repress dissent, for the truth is the mortal enemy of the lie, and thus by extension, the truth is the greatest enemy of the state.
Transposition, two things change places.
Photographing the model against a blue screen. It will later be possible to add different backgrounds and other moving objects to the scene.
Results? Enough to keep us all dreaming.
transformation. One thing turns into another one.
Back on the ground in the water tank on orbit, essentially the same picture.
And then natural laws defied, and this can be a levitation, something floats.
All he lacked, he said, was the hula hoop to run down the length of her body to prove there are no hidden wires or strings attached.
The broad masses of a nation are always more easily corrupted in the deeper strata of their emotional nature than consciously or voluntarily. And thus, in the primitive simplicity of their minds, they're more readily fall victims to the big lie than the small lie. Since they themselves often tell small lies in little matters, but would be ashamed to resort to large-scale falsehoods. It would never come into their heads to fabricate colossal untruths, and they would not believe that others could have the impudence to distort the truth so infamously. Even though the facts, which prove this to be so, may be brought clearly to their minds, they will still doubt and waver and will continue to think that there may be some other explanation.
Closing doors, this is a magic and sleight of hand term. It means canceling out possible methods in the audience's mind. In other words, if I have three coins and I want to make these coins disappear, the first thing I might do is show you that they are solid silver coins by showing you both sides. Next, I would probably explain that my sleeves are rolled up. I want to point that out so you actually see that my sleeves are rolled up. I'm going to keep all of the coins in view, in frame, and I'm going to move slowly. And with all of those things in mind, if you watch the three coins, your brain actually starts to trick itself into thinking that what you're watching is real magic. Because if enough doors are closed, that is the only answer, which is why I show you the front and back of my hands. Watch that second coin right here. That one is gone. And while you're busy thinking about that second coin, the third one has already left. And that's how you close doors.
It's a Kansas City shuffle. They look right. And you
not everybody can be a robot polisher.
We're rolling.
There's a tremendous amount of people that literally believe that space is not real. It's all bullshit. It's all fake.
I'm on the print. I think that's awfully good. That one and the one before it were pretty good.
We have about 15 seconds.
The thing that's compelling is that there's some faking going on.
We can rehearse it. Said, go back and we'll rehearse it and see how it looks.
Use the second marker there.
They're trying to keep us from the knowledge that God has created this place as a very special place.
Right.
And so by pretending that it's round, they are controlling us. Right. We're thinking that we're not exceptional and we're not lucky.
So coming up right now.
Right, rehearsal, guys.
Okay. All right, this is just rehearsal. Ready and action.
Space is fake.
Trouble in space this morning as the International Space Crew attempted a spacewalk outside the station. Here's a live look at the astronauts. Well, I don't believe that's real.
Where's their spacesuit?
It's not that it doesn't exist. Of course it exists. We see
right,
it.
Right, of course.
But space is fake sounds ridiculous. Like we're looking at it and it's fake. That's ridiculous. That's not what it means. It means that all the information we got about all those lights in the sky.
Yeah, something
else.
They're lying to us.
Why would NASA
lie?
The thing that you begin to learn, because this is magic, is to, number one, dissuade you, disrupt you, to present you with an illusion that your brain cannot distinguish between what is real.
The actual pad is in the distance, well beyond those trees, so we'll get to see a little spark travel up through this fog.
Remote location, which, you know, it's obviously important that it has to be here.
Wonderful spot because we have very little air and we're in traffic, so.
Keep in mind that nobody is actually aboard the drone ship, so, and it's 200 miles away.
In the middle of the Atlantic.
It is in the middle of the ocean.
Cannot go near the rocket site. No one can go near it.
That's the worst thing about our imagination. Our brain has a very difficult time distinguishing between what is real and illusion.
We have a cool animation to show you what's going on.
We're going to be showing you a graphic.
Be sure to follow the animation.
There'll still be some raindrops on the screen. That's not surprising. We have rockets. We don't have windscreen wipers, but we'll do the best we can.
Looks like we might have a little bit of problem with the video.
We lost video feed.
We lost satellite signals.
And we've just lost signal again, we're being told, unfortunately.
Behind me, you can see the deep, dark velvet obscured somewhat by some beautiful smoke.
To the magic of television. It does look like it's foggy there. It may make it a little bit difficult for us to see today's mission.
I don't think we have a reliable video for it right now, so I'm not sure if we're going to see it exactly perfectly.
Exactly what we saw is exactly what you saw.
And you never drop the con. You never break. Die with the lie.
Space is tough, especially whenever you're trying to show video from space.
On its way back to the drone ship,
we've seen almost a doubling in terms of improvement on on-time performance since last year. That is a reflection of all the work that we've done across the ecosystem together with our partner airlines, with agencies, reducing processing time, reducing wait times, and fine-tuning operations with our air carrier partners. And we see the great results that have come from that.
This is really sort of the modern world. It's some corporate spokesperson standing up and lying to you while the truth is on a big board right behind her. And yet there's no like irony, there's no hint that she's covering anything up. She's actually seems like she's being very very sincere in her belief that they've fixed everything, when on a big giant board right behind her in red text, delayed, 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 delayed. And she's sitting there going, nothing's delayed anymore. Isn't that nice? Isn't that wonderful? We fixed all of the delays and everybody's on time. Delayed, delayed, delayed. She might as well be Karine Jean-Pierre.
It's not just day. These are scientists. These are experts.
She might as well be John Kirby.
A bunch of malarkey. There's nothing to it.
This is just where we are now. You can either believe reality in your own eyes and what you see and experience, or you can believe the ridiculous lies out of the spokespeople and the media lapdogs who repeat their lies.
For thousands of years, the general public thought that the Earth was flat and everything revolved around it.
Like if you go to ancient Egypt, you're going to find flat Earth cosmology. If you go to ancient Hebrew, ancient Near East, you name it, flat Earth cosmology.
The flat Earth model shared by the ancients was one where we lived within a sphere, upon a flat surface, and surrounded by a massive dome, like a fishbowl, or the Truman Show.
Why? Because it looked flat.
Everything that we see looks like we're on a flat, not moving plane.
It's not just what's happening with our ego. It kind of made sense. When you thought about it, when you thought about it,
when you thought about it.
Kindergarten.
So they lie. Have you figured this out? They lie to you.
Then Nicolaus Copernicus came around with his spanking new theory.
The theory?
The world is merely a tiny speck in the universe.
We know the Earth is not flat.
The Earth is round?
Not flat.
We know that the Earth is round.
There's a silent war happening between psychos and schizos. The population for both are very small, but one group is more likely to become CEOs and the other is more likely to become homeless. Schizos are good at pattern recognition and can notice the psychos. Normies aren't as good at detecting psychos, and psychos relish it and dominate them because of this. Yes, it's all about how to handle the sheep.
Every time you see a picture from those people, those astronauts in space, you see part of the curve of the Earth.
Getting that shot really was an amazing feeling. It hits you.
I mean, you can't go around saying the world is flat and still do commerce.
Got lost. Stuff happens. It's 40 years ago.
We know they lie. They know we know they lie. And they lie anyway. That's how you treat a slave.
They say that they're not muzzling you as they strap the muzzle on your face. If you're being told I'm not muzzling you, but you can feel a muzzle being put around your mouth, I wonder which you believe. I'm not muzzled. He said I'm not muzzled. It's like, I'm sorry, I can't hear you through your muzzle, sir.
Every time you stayed safe and stayed home, you were making things better for your neighbors, You were sacrificing for the good of all.
We don't have time for a meeting of the Flat Earth Society.
Earth really is round.
This, the Earth is flat, people, is just flat out wrong.
Sudden adult death syndrome is not linked to vaccines, nor is SADS a new condition.
There's always been transgender children.
Hi, kids.
The young kids.
Are you a boy? Are you a girl?
There is no such thing.
Maybe you're somewhere in between.
Those are the childlike lies of a psychopath.
They know they're lying to you. They use it to put you in fear.
Can actually control exactly what people think.
The Flat Earth Society are on the wrong side of history.
Vaccines are safe and effective.
And because some flat earthers, especially those in places of influence, choose to peddle fiction, we're losing more of our loved ones today.
There are a lot of flat earth Nazis.
Flat earth Nazis?
Yeah, we're talking fringe of the fringe.
It's amazing. It really is amazing how their reaction shows how effective this stuff is.
You just ponder the potential realities of the world and its possible roundness.
Spinning. Spinning.
The reaction shows the lie.
Go read a book, an actual book.
It should embarrass you. It should embarrass your families. It should embarrass the fine schools you went to. It should embarrass the NBA.
I don't think this is funny, actually. Like, we can laugh at it, but I don't think it's funny.
Let's take a quick moment of silence for that thought.
I mean, that's the dumbest thing a public figure has said in my lifetime. It is one of them. I really don't think it's funny.
Of all the things that makes you react with such vitriol, ego, intensity, it shouldn't matter at all to people. Oh, it just makes you sound totally insane! No, that reaction showed me that there's truth to it.
They have to tell you how to think, because if they didn't, then you might actually look for yourself. It's actually perfectly reasonable, totally normal, was the absolute standard for most of human history.
What I'm gonna do is teach you how to think. Train your mind.
We have to train ourselves to trust the data.
The entire point of the Copernicus system that is being utilized now is to try to prove there is no up, there is no down, there is no heaven above, there is no nothing. There is no right, there is no wrong.
There is no such thing as not moving.
There is no up or down.
Not everybody can be a robot polisher.
Fires will be kindled to testify that 2 and 2 make 4. Swords will be drawn to prove that leaves are green in the summer.
Really fascinated by flat earthers.
I am open to everything now. I'm open to things that I never thought I would have been open to.
Lots of people are. I certainly am.
Yeah. After, you know, I mean, I think we've seen in the media and in the government, what we've seen these past 2.5-3 years, I mean, who knows what the fuck they're really telling us.
I've realized that everything in the news is BS.
Yeah. We've all been looking at them in awe, gushing over them.
Truly dazzling. Look at this thing. Isn't it beautiful? The clearest image of the so-called cartwheel galaxy.
NASA scientists are saying they're even better than what they had hoped for. They're stunning.
Yeah, they knew they would be good. They just did not know that they would be this good.
Each one is better than the last.
Even if we're not quite sure we understand what these gorgeous Webb telescope images are actually showing.
You can't see infrared.
Okay.
But the color you would see if your eyes could see infrared. Oh. So it's authentic and legit.
I mean, it's almost too much to even comprehend.
I mean, it looks like a painting. I mean, it looks like abstract artwork.
It looked like a painting with all the colors and dragon in the foreground.
I felt I was going to a gallery. This is an art piece, this thing.
It almost looks like Star Wars.
When
you watch it, it looks like it's something out of a science fiction film.
It looks absolutely unreal and animated.
Like R2-D2 coming out of the payload bay.
I think it looks so ridiculous and impossible.
It was almost like something out of a film or out of something that someone had created graphically.
These are cosmic sculptures.
With an untrained eye, this is a rat speck.
Those aren't little dots of light in the sky. Those are real bodies. They're interesting places out there.
Blobs of light, and now they are real objects.
The detail you see is going to be real.
And they're real.
And that shows you that really is the Earth's limb.
This is real, what's happening.
You can tell it's real because it looks so fake, honestly.
It almost looks fake.
And we'd like to compliment NASA on the orbiter model that they got for us to take these pictures.
This thing really does have a
a Star Wars effect. More Star Warsy than Star Wars, I think.
And no, it is not a model. We saw it with our own eyes, and that's what it was.
It feels very, very real. That's what you're after here.
So when we're in that capsule waiting for launch, we're just running our procedures.
You could almost, you know, trick us.
Say that we were in the simulator and it wasn't real.
And we knew that it wasn't a simulator anymore. This is the real thing.
Simulations seem as real as the mission.
I promise we are not playing a trick on you. This is real. It is science. It is rocket science.
We feel like they're real.
We're moving 6 times faster than we would in the real world.
We get accused of doing this in a hangar someplace in Texas, and so that last sequence with the disc was our proof that this was on board the orbiter in a micro-G environment.
Natural position that the body kind of assumes with the hands and the arms out extended out in front of you. And that's real.
Space is real.
So you can convince yourself that you see what's in these galaxies.
So I think there's a good bridge here to make between science and art.
To transform into something real.
The views of our blue marble in the blackness of space now capturing the imagination. The imagination now
capturing
the imagination of a new generation.
Really captures people's imagination. It's just capture my imagination every time. It's hard to even imagine that that's true. Makes it seem a little bit easier to imagine. I could barely imagine.
I just cannot even imagine.
You almost couldn't believe that it was happening.
It takes to imagine, much less attempt a mission this ambitious.
Kind of blows my mind. Almost hard to wrap your head around. A little unbelievable to me.
This is a new era of the unbelievable.
Discoveries that were miracles a few short years ago are accepted as commonplace today. Many of the things that seem impossible now will become realities tomorrow.
Crossroads of science fiction and reality.
I'm still having a hard time believing this is real.
We're gonna go do this and it's impossible, but we did it.
Once unthinkable, they're now on the cusp of doing the seemingly impossible.
Space agency saying this will never be done. There's no, it's not possible to land the first stage. And they did it.
Smart people figured out how to make all that work, and that's amazing to me that we have people in our country that know how to do that.
The impossible comes possible.
The way they could fix it over a billion miles, nothing but radio waves, was truly remarkable. Truly remarkable.
No aerodynamic or aerothermal test facility can recreate the conditions that we will see.
Something that could never be accomplished in a laboratory here on Earth.
Power is on the order of about 1/20 billionth the amount of power required to power my digital watch.
The accuracy required to reach this remote planet has been compared to a golfer sinking a putt 1,000 miles away.
It's kind of incredible to think that that vehicle lifts off on top of a bunch of rocket engines, pushing it out into space. You do all that stuff, and then it comes back in and it lands like this, like an airplane. Unbelievable. I don't know where we got all the people that knew how to make that work, but we do.
Making the impossible possible.
They were so excited. Their faces, it was amazing.
I've seen a group of people more excited, like freaked out excited, like the looks in those people's eyes.
Oh my God!
Everybody can be a robot polisher.
Welcome to Storytime from Space.
We're going to the moon.
Join us.
Why do you think we haven't been back to the moon?
Historically, you'd have to say Apollo was kind of a fluke.
We've diversified.
NASA's Artemis program will land the first woman and the first person of color on the moon.
We are going.
We don't even have a target date for when we can anticipate a moon landing.
We're such an anomalous situation.
Which might all seem a bit strange.
We're going.
What you realistically believe will put a land a crew on the moon again?
Within a decade.
We are going.
By 2020.
By 2025.
We are going.
Back to the moon, back to the future, and this time, back to stay.
Returning to the moon is an important step for our space program.
We'll return American astronauts to the moon.
It seems weird that we'd be so much more advanced now and we haven't gone back.
I agree. It's totally weird.
We're going.
And this is how.
Mission equity.
Why does it seem like we're worse at this than over 50 years ago?
I am gay.
I am gay.
I am gay.
I am a queer woman. I am NASA.
I am a lesbian. I am NASA.
I am a transgender woman. I am NASA.
I am a queer woman, and I am NASA.
I am non-binary. I use they, them. I am NASA.
We still have a little ways to go. We're casting our net wider and wider.
We need gay scientists.
Hispanic doctors.
We need black engineers.
We belong.
We belong.
We belong here.
It's not all going to plan.
We heard the announcement that the Artemis mission to orbit the moon is going to be delayed, and then the next Artemis mission to land on the moon for the first time in decades is going to be further delayed. We saw just recently a very hyped SpaceX Starships blowing up after takeoff in the US last year.
With another setback when the Peregrine moon lander ended its mission in flames over the Pacific.
It was like reaching into the future and bringing a technology forward that normally wouldn't be there. Like, that was not the natural pace of technology development.
By the 1970s, there was a failure rate of about 20% of missions. In the 2020s, that number is closer to 45%.
We've had 50 years to develop the technologies. They've become cheaper. They've become better understood. But at the same time, you have all of these companies that are just learning.
I am non-binary, I am gay, I use they, them, and it just felt really nice to see someone else in the room using those pronouns, and I made sure to introduce myself with my pronouns so that they could know, you're not the only one here, there's someone here who understands you and really just wants the best for you.
Really important that we can show that visibility is safe. And that you can absolutely be a part of the team and loved and valued for who you are.
It's never too late.
So we haven't had a lot of experience landing on the moon. We have had experience landing on Mars, landing on asteroids. I wouldn't say that we're out of practice as much as we just have a number of new participants.
At NASA, we're on a mission of equity.
Use science, data, and technology to advance equity.
Diversity and equity and inclusion and accessibility. NASA is just a small piece of the Biden administration's efforts to advance equal opportunity, but we should lead the way.
We also implemented a unity initiative on advancing racial equity and support for underserved communities through the federal government. We're on diversity, equity, inclusion, and accessibility in the federal workforce. Our strong commitment to DEIA is one of the important reasons that NASA has been ranked number one among large agencies for employee engagement for the past 9 consecutive years. And we've also been ranked number one in inclusiveness in the past 7 consecutive years. At NASA, we make air and space available for everyone. People don't have to hold their breath for fear of being a victim of discrimination, harassment, or retaliation. And space refers to our commitment to providing room for everyone to be authentic, to belong, and fully contribute to our agencies.
And so we all know that diversity in space is needed.
We're going to the moon.
We're not going anywhere.
Not everybody can be a robot polisher.
Is outer space gay or straight?
I wonder if you would recommend locking down schools if you had to do it all over again.
You're okay. You're not gonna get COVID if you have these vaccinations.
First of all, I didn't recommend locking anything down.
Vaccinated people do not get sick.
I recommended to the president that we shut the country down.
Night comes zooming level play, missing curves, space is gay, Boston bombing falls flat, Joe Biden's a pedo. Dr. Fauci always lies, Stevie Wonder is a blind, fake career, we shall see it down the rabbit hole. Bilderberg's fake bomb, Mike Obama, huge dumb bar, Rock the Kenyan guy, has your wife identified. Warp speed, vaccine, J&J, ultra jeans, my dope, kiss your sweet ass goodbye.
Why do you trust these lies? You must be discerning, cause the world's not turning. No more astronauts or wires. This world is faking it all, we know it's not, we're exposing.
Department, NSA, CDC, and TSA, IRS, CIA, and NASA is a crock. SpaceX, Space Force, space is clearly fake, of course. Devon Island is Mars, Elon Musk is launching cars. Einstein was a queen, 2 more weeks of quarantine. Jesse Smollett, fake attack, George Floyd, swallow crack. Said he couldn't breathe at all, overdosed on fentanyl. Sick of these clowns, let's get the circus shut down. Bin Laden in the sea, Robbie Parker smiling. Epstein didn't die, flight logs are classified. California communist, you swim, tops the list. Mask your kids, stay inside, for your health from formaldehyde. Euro doesn't eat bugs, world economic thugs. Klaus Schwab, Castro, piss on Justin Trudeau. Psychos, the elite, Bill Gates are tracking me. Why do you trust these liars? You must be discerning, cause the world's not turning. No more astronauts or wires. This world is making you know, and now it's time we expose it. 9-11, no planes, another dream, another day. Looting 7 falling from the plane they're calling. Nano thermite concrete, possible found in the street. Lucky Larry Silverstein, wounded like a slot machine. Shanksville, Red Pill, Rumsfeld. Cause the world's not turning. No more astronauts or wires. We are sick of these clowns. Let's get this sucker shut down. Climate change, MSN, selling fear on CNN. Moonshot, space walk, Alfred Dalton. All the astronauts who died have a twin still alive. Challenger, master plan, Buzz Aldrin is drunk again. We have moon rocks, petrified. Let's shock, yelling live. The rockets fly, CGI. Planet stone, CGI. The ISS, RBS. It's Earth flat, actually yes. Not dinosaurs, eyes of course. I can't take it anymore. Why would you trust these liars? Maybe concerning, that's a building is burning. Maybe come on, call these liars. They deserve a takedown for saying we go around, 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 around. Why do we trust these liars? We must be discerning, cause the world's not turning. No more astronauts or wires. This world is waking, you know. Now it's time we expose it. Trust these liars. You must be discerning, cause the world's not turning. No more astronauts or wires. This world is breaking, you know. Now it's time we expose it.
I basically got ratioed on Twitter
for saying that the moon landing happened. The most recent survey I've seen conducted in 2019 found that only about 60% of the public strongly disagrees with the theory that the moon landing was fake. And that leaves about 40% who do not strongly disagree with the theory that the moon landing is fake. Perhaps most commonly cited piece of evidence to support moon landing denialism is that we haven't gone back. If we really landed on the moon, then why haven't we ever gone back? In 1970, we were sending rockets to the moon. That's true.
When I was a kid, we had spaceships. And we had this thought that it was going to be spaceships, and then the next thing was going to be colonies, and then we were just going to keep pushing out for the lunar colony first, and then Mars was going to be next, and we were just going to keep going, and this was our destiny.
It's true that, you know, if you were alive in 1970, you probably would have assumed that by the year 2024, we'd be landing humans on the moons of Jupiter. Right by now.
Is it the future? Is it the key to reaching the stars? Or is it just 5 totally awesome days away from mom and dad?
Fantasyland. Here is a world of imagination, hopes, and dreams. Magic and make-believe are reborn, and fairy tales come true. Fantasyland is dedicated to the young and the young in heart. To those who believe that when you wish upon a star, your dreams do come true.
Time is 1986. The place is a city of the future, where a trip to the moon is an everyday thing. Time is 1986.
We didn't get there.
They don't seem to have ever gotten back to that basic idea of human progress.
Now, to top it all off, IQ scores are declining and people are generally becoming less competent and less skilled.
Why?
The question is there something that the US government isn't telling us?
Now, the moon landing has reams and reams and reams of evidence.
HC telemetry data is even in existence, and as I said, even if we have it, we don't have machines to play it back.
But your own research has shown the telemetry data is missing.
That's right. Right. We have been unable to track it down. I mean, we don't know where this telemetry data ended up, and we don't know what path it may have taken. So. Unfortunately, I'm afraid I can't really give you much of a clue as to where this data ended up and whether it still exists or not.
Interviews with the astronauts who went there, footage from other lunar probes that have gone to the moon or orbited it. There's even a laser reflector that was left on the surface. You can bounce a laser off of it today.
Initiating laser on retro reflector from Apollo 15.
This is a real experiment that can be conducted right now today to confirm that the reflector was left there.
When you think about it, this is extraordinary. A laser is shot from Earth and makes a round trip of over 500,000 miles.
The ultimate proof of man's moon mission.
Oh, that's very cool.
Now, we'll be able to see the beam when it leaves, but it won't be strong enough when it comes back to be seen by the naked eye.
In fact, it's something that can only be picked up by the most sensitive of collectors, and hopefully, when we get that photon back, we'll see a spike like that.
The spike?
There it is. There's the spike.
That's the return from Apollo 15.
It's the moon. We hit the moon.
That is so cool.
That's your big experiment? Oh, that for a lion on the screen?
Dude, people are fucking retarded now. Like, the world's filled with literal idiots. Do you think a laser can shoot 240,000 miles?
Now, it'll take much more sophisticated equipment than the average person has laying around.
100 billion times more powerful than this is. That's what you gotta have to make it to the moon and back.
You're telling me you're on a ball going 1,000 miles an hour and hit a little mirror and it can bounce back and hit your little box and you go, wow, we went to the moon. You literally believe that? How do you believe that? Try and bounce a laser 1,000 yards and hit where you started. 1,000 yards.
All right, can you ping the reflector? There it is. That's what, like 500 meters away, would you say?
350.
Okay, now try and do 1 mile.
The fact that we can do this is the only way of definitively proving that there are man-made objects on the moon.
Ultimate proof of man's moon mission.
Lasers bouncing off of freaking reflectors planted on the moon's surface won't convince them. Nothing will.
Take a minute and just think about how a laser going a round trip of 500,000 miles on a ball spinning 1,000 miles an hour to reflect back to a box, and then they say that's proof that someone fucking played golf on the moon! It's fiction, it's lies, it's bullshit. No one went to the moon. There's no evidence whatsoever that anyone's ever been to the moon. There's actually no evidence that you can go to the moon. And this is the shit that distorts young minds.
According to the conspiracy theorists, NASA did a shoddy job of pulling it off.
Ridiculous. It looks stupid. It looks ridiculous and dumb. There's no way
people went on the moon.
There's no way.
It's just laughable. It's held together by literal tape. Look at that. That is tape, Tim. That's space tape, bud.
Simple scotch tape, haphazardly placed here and there, as if it were a last-minute job.
Other than the foil, what is that? What is that?
A Twinkie? No, I'm sure it's some super important and necessary high-tech device. Look at the buckling, warping, and indentation.
There is no explanation for the sloppiness in the construction of the lunar module, with the engines covered with aluminum foil, the external panels not even lining up with each other, and the scotch tape that seems added at the last moment, just to keep together pieces that would otherwise fall apart.
And you can tell it's real because it looks so fake, honestly.
You know there's got to be people that are like, dude, come on, you can't do tinfoil in a car. No one's going to believe that.
Dude, like, there's people that lost their mind when they saw the limb. When they looked at it, they're like, what?
Yeah.
What? He goes, yes.
Yeah, you wait. They'll believe whatever we show them.
They like it. They go, let's make it fucking ridiculous.
Let's make it fucking ridiculous. Because it's almost humiliating, you know? one. Let's make it. Let's just convince these dummies of something so stupid, you know, just to.
Yeah, it's just dumb
shit. Just to humiliate us.
Are we truly to believe that NASA has spent all this money to send a vehicle covered with loose pieces of cardboard into space?
The memo recommended, for example, arguing that a conspiracy of this magnitude could not have been kept secret.
How many people would need to be involved for it to work?
Which is an argument we still hear today about things like 9/11.
And finally, they say that footage of the lunar module taking off from the moon's surface
is clearly fake.
Or did they just want to believe? Oh, they're still like holding people's imagination. The average person thinks they're standing on a spinning ball. Right now, 2022, they think they're standing on a ball that's spinning 1,000 miles an hour in infinite blackness. Even people that know the moon landing's ridiculous and NASA lies all the time, they still think they're standing on a spinning ball, even though their Bible, their Quran, all these things say there's no chance. They're literally like, I'm standing on a spinning ball right now. And everyone's like, why don't you prove it's not spinning? I'm like, look around. You see that? You see all of it? Oh no, but the atmosphere spins at the same time and it's all relative. It's so fucking stupid. That's why people are like, you know, Big Bear, I really like you. I listen to you, but I just can't get on board the flat earth thing. I mean, there's just no evidence the earth is flat. We're obviously on a spinning ball. I'm like, there's zero evidence you're on a spinning ball. Look around, guys. Does that look like you're on a ball going 1,000 miles an hour?
Anyone could go outside right at this very moment and confirm this point yourself.
Most globe people have never thought about anything. They're just like, y'all so very stupid. I mean, you can do the math, guys. The math is right there. Everyone's, prove you're on a flat plane. Okay, there it is. It's right there. That's the flat, not moving plane. How about you prove you're on a spinning ball?
But you don't know basic science. The light curves around the earth because of gravity.
Oh my God, you're fucking brain dead. My 8-year-old always says it doesn't feel like it's spinning because it's not spinning. That's fucking insane. I mean, it's more insane than transgenderism. All these right-wingers are like, oh my God, a 5-year-old boy cannot be a 5-year-old girl, which is obviously true. But the idea that you're on a spinning ball is literally crazier. Because at least boys and girls both have like lungs and hearts and hands and shit. Like that's, like the spinning ball thing is like retarded. But I know it triggers people and then they feel very suicidal and scared. They go Manchuria Candidate when you say flat earth. Yeah, I get why. They think you think it's a flat disc in space. I get how stupid that sounds. Flat earthers don't actually think that. It's a straw man. I don't believe in global warming.
So you want the earth to burn? You want the earth to die?
I think transgenderism is child abuse.
You won't accept people for what they are?
I'm a flat earther.
You think it's a disc in the middle of space? Where's the water fall off to?
Okay. You're retarded.
If you think the flat earth is flat, then how does it spin around the sun when it's flat disk in the space?
It's the ultimate psyop to get you to feel like you have no responsibility in the world. It's intended to make you feel meaningless when the truth is the exact opposite. Exactly. You don't matter. It's the earth is just one grain of sand in an infinite beach spinning an infinite nothing. And it's crazy seeing Christians like believe in evolution and space and all this stuff that 100% contradicts the Bible.
Discoveries that were miracles a few short years ago are accepted as commonplace today. Many of the things that seem impossible now will become realities tomorrow.
It's total bullshit.
It will be many years yet before our plans can fully materialize.
And I am absolutely convinced the emphasis here on space is absolutely vital to our
new world order. When we are successful, and we will be, we have a real chance at this new world order.
Not everybody can be a robot polisher.
What's being denied is one of the greatest achievements in human history.
Really happy to see what we see from the moon and, of course, looking back on the Earth.
an achievement claimed by Americans for America.
That's us. That's home. 232,000 miles away from Earth.
There's the spike.
This guy does not work in science. He's a comedian playing a character.
I basically got ratioed on Twitter.
Or do flat earthers just like feel inferior? Is this where this place, where this comes from? No, a lot of us were huge into science fiction. I was huge into Stargate SG-1, Stargate Atlantis, Babylon 5. I actually grew up being a sci-fi kid.
Ask a sci-fi book collection. I used to be a massive sci-fi nerd. I bought into all this stuff. It's not like I was like trying to, you know, live in a fairy tale land, and so that's why I became a flat earther.
Everyone has the same story.
Yeah, we all were globe earthers, in case you didn't know.
I was violently opposed to it. I was mad at people that would bring it up.
A friend of mine was posting all these things on Facebook. It was pissing me off.
There's no fucking way the Earth is flat.
These people still exist. How can anyone think the Earth is flat?
That's fucking insane.
Flat Earth? Like, that makes no sense. Like, then how does stuff not fall off the side?
Shut the fuck up.
What about all these satellites they're claiming that are going up to space? Where are the waves going from your cell phone?
Everybody that's into Flat Earth, it was very hard for them to get into it and admit it.
I was already had this thought of, you know, what it was, a globe, and what right. They told us.
Everyone has the same story. When I first heard about Flat Earth, I thought it was the dumbest shit ever. I thought it was a CIA psyop. It must be some kind of distraction.
God, this is a fucking nightmare. I can't be a Flat Earth person.
Exact same story. Everybody. No one just believes it right away.
So when my dad decided to change to be into a Flat Earther, I took that as a challenge, and I tried to prove him wrong. But in order to prove him wrong, I had to know what the actual argument for the Flat Earth was.
The only problem with the Flat Earth rabbit hole, whatever you want to call it, is it's kind of hard to beat.
I'm 57 years into believing that the Earth is round.
Started going into the research and boom.
The Flat Earthers, I mean, they have a lot of good, compelling shit to say.
Oh, fucking stupid.
Unbelievable. Like,
how the fuck are we supposed to handle all of this?
There's nothing compares. Nothing compares to the whole quote-unquote flat earth research rabbit hole.
It's got a lot more to it than I think people would first assume.
Look into it like you're investigating it. Just look into both sides. There's a reason why it's becoming huge. There's a reason.
I have to question my own worldview and my own belief system, and thinking Flat Earth was stupid, which is where most of us start out at. I never would have assumed I would have become a Flat Earther. So you have to realize that all these people that do, they have to literally be convinced against their own belief system and their own worldview to get to the point that they're at now.
God damn it! The Earth is clearly not a fucking spinning ball!
Wait, why does it all make sense?
Why is this all fake? Official NASA website releasing footage that's CGI.
Maybe really this is lost knowledge. Maybe it truly is lost knowledge. What humans are, what our planet is, and what this is all about.
There's nothing more mind-blowing than realizing that we've been lied to the point where we don't even know where we are. I can't think of any other experience topping that.
This can't be reality.
Even like the so-called smartest people in the world will all be like, these flat earthers are retarded, you know?
You know, no one with a brain believes anything about the flat earth. It's absurd.
It's just ridiculous. It's absolutely, I know nothing about science. And I don't want to get mad at them. It's just that it's ridiculous.
Plus, flat earthers know that once a person says that, they're basically just admitting that they either haven't even bothered to look, or they're not smart enough to understand that the math doesn't add up. One of the two things.
I really just have questions, don't I? That's all I have. I've been lied to so much by my government, by the education system. I don't trust any of it. I don't trust any of it, quite frankly. It's all fake and gay.
Guarantee you, NASA is lying to us.
Yeah, and it's the truth.
It's the truth. And it sets you free.
I've never seen a former flat earther. Nobody's ever seen what the actual shape of the earth is. And then be like, you know what?
Neil deGrasse Tyson really does give me a good argument
because it's literally ridiculous.
I would rather be thought as a moron for not trusting criminals than a fucking sellout and a traitor for defending them.
Not everybody can be a robot polisher.
The establishment wants a semi-lobotomized, quasi-retarded population. They don't want you thinking for yourself. They don't want you researching for yourself. They don't want you to be resourceful. They want you to take whatever it is they regurgitate to you, accept it as truth, and then move on, paint your body, and go to your favorite football team game. Meanwhile, you're having everything stolen from you in the past, present, and future. But you're a semi-lobotomized, quasi-retarded member of the population, so you don't even know what's going on. You're essentially a dodo bird getting eaten up for sport.
Listen, all I'm saying is if they tell me after I get my degree, after all of that trouble I had in so many of these classes, man.
If they tell me the earth is flat.
After all that, I will never forgive them. I'll tell you that much. It's been 4 years, okay? That's 4 years of my life right there.
I'll go on record right now. If I find out a week from now that the earth is flat and this has all been a lie, okay, I'll have a major crisis in terms of what else could be fixed.
Oh yeah, I mean it would be a big coming to Jesus moment for sure. Like,
oh yeah.
Like, what?
For me, it would change everything that I understand about the universe, and it would be a humongous upheaval in my existential existence.
So, you know, if I imagine myself already being there, then, yeah, you know, all of history, all of everything. Like,
what else could be a lie?
The disco dancing, Oscar Wilde reading, Streisand ticket holding, friend of Dorothy, know what I'm saying?
World's first planetary defense test.
Which honestly sounds like something from a science fiction movie.
NASA's planning to ram a refrigerator-sized spacecraft into an asteroid roughly the size of the Pyramid of Giza.
At a speed of 4,000 miles per second.
That's like shooting a BB gun at a freight train.
Not everybody can be a robot polisher.
It's all fake and I think. I mean, you know, kind of like space.
Everything that comes out of NASA is fake and I mean, really, like, that James Webb telescope, do you really believe any of those pictures are real?
It lets some dream a little. For so many, that's really what it is all about.
Like, how many videos of Neil deGrasse Tyson do we need to see with his mouth wide open pointing, soy-facing over these fake pictures to, you know, how many of those do you need to finally convince you that space is amazing?
This is what it's about. We are having fun.
It's gonna be fun.
We are excited.
So excited.
So excited.
Amazing.
To see, like, the actual dots on the screen for real.
What an exciting, exciting time.
Exceeded my expectations. And
it really looks
just amazing.
And it looks, it's like adorable. It's this little moon. It's so cute.
Wow, look at that.
What exactly are we seeing here?
Well, it's an incredible image.
Not photos, images. They're images, not photos. There's a difference. They're images.
Do you know the difference?
Photo would be you took a photo of it. Images, you had some intern do some cool Photoshop.
It was almost like something out of a film or out of something that someone had created graphically.
This is an art piece, this thing.
It looks like a painting with all the colors and dragon in the foreground.
It's like abstract artwork.
Okay. So, wow. Very cool. What a cool image, NASA. Wow, that's Neptune's rings. Wow, what a cool Photoshop.
It's truly dazzling. Like, breathtaking.
They're stunning.
Each one is better than the last.
Sounds made up to me.
Sounds made up, yeah. Me too.
So NASA's in the business of faking everything.
Are you denying space?
A little bit. A little bit.
Space is kind of fake.
So fake.
So fake.
The fakest looking crap I've ever seen in my life.
Ridiculous. It looks stupid. It looks ridiculous and dumb.
It's tape, Tim. That's space tape, bud.
It's just laughable.
So NASA has lied to us for decades.
The NASA resumes they receive to work there, it's like, are you proficient in Photoshop? It's like, what?
You know, we own the science and we think that the world, you know, should know it.
And she said she wants you to know that they own the science, because that's how science works.
It's all stupid. It's all stupid. Science is stupid now.
And they're still doing it.
NASA definitely made impact.
So dumb.
They own the science. So they can lie about it, they can manipulate it, they can deceive you, and they do.
I mean, honestly, the strangest thing about it is the fact that people are not aware of this. They're following the science until the science takes an unexpected turn, and then they just are off the path. They just are continuing down the trail they were going down, despite the fact that they were following the science. The science changed, but they just kept on going, just ignoring scientific revelations that do not comport with their preordained image of what they thought the science would say.
We are conditioned to think that the heliocentric model is scientifically superior to the geocentric model. But when we apply scientific reasoning, this is not the case. Contrary to popular thought, the scientific community has disputed the heliocentric model for centuries. The empirical evidence tells us that either the surface of the Earth is a flat plane, or the planet is at least 100 times bigger than we are told.
Funny that, you know, those flat Earth videos, you know, that gets demonized so much, but it's kind of a compelling
argument. The Earth.
I know that triggers the fuck out of people, but
yeah, it gets people pissed. They hate that. I don't even think that triggers people so much. As soon as you say, oh, I don't think we're going 1,100 miles plus 66,600, then plus, you know, the audio, 4.2 million miles of ever-expanding universe, it's like, man, you should go to shop at CVS. Like, there's insane.
But you notice, there's no debate. Where's the scientific debate? Where are the individuals that disagree with the concepts and conclusions of the we own the science crowd?
You debated anyone about this?
I have not debated anybody about this. My feeling is that I won't debate the science.
Why wouldn't you debate the science?
Because the science has already been debated in the scientific system.
I asked you to debate one of them flat earth guys.
No, I don't. I can't. No.
We talked about it and we were going to have him on Skype.
No, for years, I believed that we didn't go to the moon.
What changed you?
Mostly talking to Neil deGrasse Tyson.
And like I say, by then, for me, I don't have the energy to fight all of that. I just teach people sort of how to think. I understand how susceptible one can be when you're confronted with what is given as evidence.
Right.
If you don't otherwise have the tools to analyze information, then one is susceptible to all manner of forces of thought that go on around you. Explain that. Oh, well, then, okay, well, then how about? And they start going down a list. And, you know, time to go to dinner, you know?
So who wins a debate? It's often the person who's charismatic, who's maybe charming, that's related to charisma, of course.
Because in a one-on-one debate, without the ability to fact check people. So let's
Why
say.
Why couldn't you fact check him?
Because, I mean, how do I do that? He says, this paper says this. And I'm saying, do you want me to read the paper?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, it would be a debate that would take a week.
So we do a week.
You can have someone who is speaking objective truths who could lose a debate. So then what is the point of the debate if one of these points of view is objectively true?
There's certain points that you could get where you would go over them and we could kind of establish those points in advance. Like where is the contention? Like where is the disagreement? And why does he feel this way and why do you feel this way? And I feel like if we established like a set of parameters or a set of areas of contention.
I will not enter a debate where I have the objectively true side of an argument and the other person does not.
I understand that, but to the average person that gets confused and doesn't know, debate would be very beneficial.
I disagree with that entirely.
No amount of evidence can convince an idiot.
That is something that should not be debated. Does not belong in front of an audience getting debated.
They don't have the debate because they know they would lose it.
Mostly talking to Neil deGrasse Tyson.
It's all a lie, folks. It's all a lie.
This could be settled.
Fires will be kindled to testify that 2 and 2 make 4. Swords will be drawn to prove that leaves are green in the summer.
At least it can be explained in a way that a rational person could have a more informed opinion of what's going on.
You want to debate something? Debate political policy.
Policy is different.
Debate that.
Not everybody can be a robot polisher.
Are you saying everybody else is wrong and you people are the only ones who are right?
Absolutely.
We're right. You're wrong.
1,000% right.
The principle is simple. It tells us we're nothing special. Tucked away in some forgotten corner of a universe in which there are far more galaxies than people. We're nothing special. There are no special places or directions in the universe. No center, no edges, no up, no down, no left or right.
The universe actually came from nothing. In fact, every measurement we can make about the universe is really consistent with a universe that came from nothing.
Nothing. Generally understood as the absence of anything, but sometimes used in modern cosmology to refer to an unseen form of something. Something from nothing. A key concept in modern cosmology.
So what did science defeat? What did they defeat in 1600, 1700? What did they really overtake?
Church.
Church. Okay. So if they admitted after 200 years, oops, the Earth is not round, it's actually flat, what would be the first thing people would go back to?
Do you think people would still follow science, or do you think they would go back to the church?
Big Bang cosmology assumes that the only thing that exists is the physical world. There's nothing beyond that.
People want to save the existing models because there's a lot that's invested in them.
The standard model is a really good model. It fits the observation very, very well.
We have a conflict between what is well-established mainstream thought and what is the testimony of experiments.
They've essentially run into dead ends.
This is the moment of truth because they have nowhere to go.
The principle is wrong. It could mean that everything we think we know about our universe is wrong. It was the natural assumption of the ancient world to see the movements in the heavens as centered upon us. From the location of Stonehenge, near Salisbury, England, we can see the standing ruins of what may be the very first astronomical observatory, constructed from an Earth-centered, fixed viewpoint around which the heavens revolve.
If you look at pictures of medieval cosmology, then you see not only the Earth and the planets, but the outer sphere. Beyond that, you would have heaven. So that the Earth was considered to be at rest, ultimately, with respect to heaven, with respect to the throne of God.
Copernican revolution is the revolution of the mobility of the Earth.
Copernican principle leads to, ultimately, the idea that there is no God.
That we are nothing compared to the splendorous universe of ours.
I think it was one of the greatest things that ever happened to us. We had this arrogance, and we got it knocked out of us. And we realized that actually
we're insignificant and the future's miserable. So those are the two things we've learned.
It always seems like we're the center of the universe, but we're not.
There's nothing special about humans.
And there are probably 100 billion solar systems in our galaxy alone.
There's nothing special about the Earth. In fact, our universe may be one among many universes. If our Earth really turns out to be special, then I would say, hey, God made a mistake.
We don't like being special, which is crazy, because we're nothing special.
We're also very brief, our 100-year lifespans. So how could we possibly be significant?
Giordano Bruno got burnt at the stake the year 1600 for writing about an infinite space.
He was burned alive in the streets of Rome in the year 1600 for simply saying that there are other worlds out there, that there's nothing essentially special about our world. So why would the Catholic Church burn this person alive in the streets of Rome? Because think about it. If there are other worlds, then the question is, are there people on these other planets? If so, do they have a savior? If so, do they have a pope? If so, how many saints do they have? Imagine a billion popes, a trillion saints. How many trinities are there?
The mind goes crazy.
Contemplating a universe, a universe of universes. And so what did the church do? They simply burned him alive.
Not everybody can be a robot polisher.
Bruno told his inquisitors at his sentencing, "It may be that you fear more to deliver judgment upon me than I fear judgment." Henceforth, science would increasingly assert its independence from the influence of the church.
Science would be destroyed. Science would be it would be the worst day they could ever possibly have, admitting that they were wrong about this.
People have had a brick wall placed in front of them because science has said certain things, and they said, you must stay over in this category here, and you cannot go into the God category because that's going to destroy our science.
People would go back to the Bible and say, oh, look, yep, it could be literally true now.
In trying to figure out all these anomalies that they see in the universe that don't fit the Copernican principle, what this leads to is creating a whole bunch of universes.
I'm a great advocate of the multiverse.
There could be an infinite number.
Billions and billions.
I call it a multiverse.
Somewhere in all those universes, there's going to be something that's not geocentric, you see. And that's how we can get out of the problem.
It's not fine-tuning. It's not religious, like some people think.
You can take anything you want and you can explain it by the multiverse.
Don't confront the face of God in the multiverse. You're just the result of a mathematical equation splitting infinitely.
It's a strange time in cosmology. It's an interesting time because we don't understand anything.
If you understand nothing, you understand everything.
So not only is all the evidence suggestive that we came from nothing, but the laws of physics tell us that it's to be expected that something comes from nothing.
Now today, fortunately, we don't burn astronomers alive anymore, which I think is a good thing.
You're describing something that is a facet of what has been grappled with for time immemorial.
Down the rabbit hole.
Now, I grew up in a world where I actually believed that conspiracy theories were the way that dumb, uninformed people explained a complex world.
Well, anyone who raises questions about the prevailing propaganda narratives is a conspiracy theorist.
There's a stable of so-called conspiracy theories that the highest levels of politics and finance, there is a shadowy cabal of pedophiles who use their power to hide the crimes they commit against children.
Carlson is sounding more and more like Alex Jones.
Within the U.S. government, there are forces wholly beyond democratic control. These forces are more powerful than the elected officials that supposedly oversee them.
Is it a stretch to say that Tucker Carlson is the new Alex Jones?
These forces can affect election outcomes. They can even hide their complicity in the murder of an American president. In other words, they can do pretty much anything they want.
Tucker Carlson is the new Alex Jones.
They constitute a government within a government, mocking by their very existence the idea of democracy.
Wait a second. Is he aligned with Alex Jones?
Are they bros?
And all these other right-wing conspiracy theorists.
There's actually research showing that people who believe conspiracies would actually be willing to engage in a conspiracy themselves.
He doesn't think that Alex Jones's views are out there, that they're crazy.
Conspiracy that does not exist.
He thinks that they're legitimate and should be debated, and he's bringing them up on his own show.
Why at a gut level do people want to believe in conspiracy theories?
Clean-cut conspiracy narratives are designed to prey on your pre-established suspicions.
Truth is painful often, and the truth is complicated.
Sometimes truth is stranger than fiction, right?
It's a whole different country from what we thought it was.
It's all fake.
When exactly did this become a thing? When did conspiracy theory become a thing? It can't always have been a phrase that springs to everybody's lips the way it does now. So I researched its history, and it was very simple. I just went to the archives of the New York Times, the Washington Post, and Time Magazine, and did a search on conspiracy theory and conspiracy theorist. And I discovered that until 1967, conspiracy theory had been used, you know, now and then, and in no consistent way. The phrase conspiracy theorist, never. Nobody ever called anybody a conspiracy theorist in print. So what happened in 1967? Well, 1967 was the year that the CIA sent its memo 1035-960 to all station chiefs worldwide, basically explaining that the problem they were faced with was the traction that certain conspiracy theorists were getting, raising questions about the Warren Report. What the memo told the CIA station chiefs to do was to contact their media assets and encourage them to attack and discredit the conspiracy theorists. And the memo actually uses that phrase. The conspiracy theorists in question is people like Mark Lane and Edward J. Epstein and others who have written books raising perfectly rational questions about the Warren Report. The memo recommended, for example, arguing that a conspiracy of this magnitude could not have been kept secret, okay? Which is an argument we still hear today about things like 9/11. You suggest to the editors or reporters you talk to that the conspiracy theorists use some material deliberately generated by communist propagandists, okay? So the memo went out, and it's no coincidence that that marks the moment when we first start to see those phrases used, and used increasingly as the decades roll by.
Now today, of course, the term conspiracy theory appears in pretty much every New York Times story about American politics. It's wielded, now as then, as a weapon against anyone who asks questions the government doesn't feel like answering.
Happen to be anti-vaxxers and conspiracy theorists.
With reasons varying from general skepticism to conspiracy theories.
A new wave of conspiracy theories that have been shared through social media.
COVID-19 is acting as an accelerant to conspiracy theories.
Conspiracy theories, voted definitely true by dipshit Uncle Quarterly.
Evil theories about, you know, did we create the pandemic? Are we trying to profit from it?
If you go online, there's no shortage of conspiracy theories.
They believe that what they're seeing on TV and what they're seeing in terms of results is a hoax perpetrated by a cabal.
Deep state.
This new world order.
That is crazy.
Insanity.
Secret cabal.
Pedophiles.
Here in Washington working to undermine the American people.
And it is trying to censor you.
They're trying to chill speech. They're trying to silence us.
To prevent the world from seeing what's really going on. Some dark story we're not getting.
Who's really controlling it all?
It's a riddle. It's a quest. It's been locked down. So our natural inclination is to find it. Find
there doesn't
hiding.
Demonic forces and shady people behind the scenes that you can't see.
The train that's never late is that it's the Jews.
Always.
Evil drink the blood of children.
In the Clintons and George Soros and Bill Gates and Anthony Fauci.
Vaccine conspiracy theories. False flag conspiracy theories.
Michelle Obama. The man.
It's a lie. It's a lie. Like 9/11 is an inside job. Sandy Hook was a false flag.
Fake stories of dead children, and it's heartbreaking.
The Oklahoma City bombing. The Boston Marathon attack.
Big lie in election denialism.
It's a lie.
Global warming and COVID-19.
Replacement theory.
Population control.
Jewish face lasers.
Transhumanism.
A lot of people don't even know what that is, and they shouldn't, because it's insane.
Bizarre.
Outlandish.
Pretty homophobic.
Crazy conspiracy theory. That's the only word for it. Crazy.
Untethered from reality.
A deep, wounded conspiracy nuttiness.
An anti-Semitism adjacent hyperventilation over globalism.
It's completely ridiculous.
Mind-numbing absurdity.
Sheer madness.
Hogwash. Dangerous.
A garbage fire.
Poison.
It couldn't be farther from the truth.
Someone calls you a conspiracy theorist, they have already lost the argument, because that epithet is a way to prevent discussion from taking place. In defending the propaganda narrative, they don't have an argument. They don't have a defense. They have none. They have none.
Americans have trusted their government less with every passing year since the killing of John F. Kennedy. Maybe this is why.
Not everybody can be a robot polisher.
They don't have an argument. They don't have a defense. They have none. They have none.
Thank you.
they're innocent bystanders who are lured into conspiracies by people like Caleb or like friend Mike Oxbig, aka Robot Polisher.
Robot Polisher, my guy.
A Robot Polisher is the dude who put together that montage of me waking up to shit. It was the seven stages of Flat Earth Awakening when I was like bargaining and angry and drunk, and it was fucking genius.
He is one of the leading voices telling people about the truth.
See, my boy, it's nature's way. Upon the weak, the strong ones prey. The human life, it's also true. The strong will try to conquer you. Ooh. And that is what you must expect unless you use your intellect.
And I mean, you know, imagine polishing a robot for 13 hours. Jesus. Right?
I think
that's a lot of polishing.
It was Klaus Schwab who said that, right? I think it's Klaus Schwab from the WEF guy. Okay, not everyone can be a robot polisher. Yeah, that's Klaus Schwab said that. I think he's talking about the future of automation of jobs and things like that is what I would imagine.
In other words, there's too many humans because once the world is run by unthinking machines, not everybody can just polish robots all day. We'll have to come up with something else for them to do. Maybe they'll just die.
I mean, I think it's a funny quote.
You'll have to use your brain for a change.
And it's a funny thing for Klaus Schwab to say. Not everyone can be a robot polisher.
Everybody could be a robot polisher.
Not everyone can be a robot polisher.
Not everyone can be a robot polisher.
It's hilarious. So I'll give it that.
It's a great quote.
Not everybody can be a robot polisher.
History of Flat Earth, look into it.
No, definitely not.
I can't, sir.
Look
I
into
just
it.
Can't.
I hear you, sir.
Fourth grade, my teacher. Cool.
Hey, you know what? You don't care, and that's fine. I'm not going to be mad at you for not caring.
No, of course
don't
not.
Be mad at me for caring, though.
It is about seeking the truth and also having the wisdom to acknowledge it.
I would rather be thought as a moron for not trusting criminals. Been a fucking sellout and a traitor for defending them.
Not everybody can be a robot polisher.
Isn't the first stage of grief denial?
Right.
I think that so much of our population is psychologically incapable of acknowledging the fact that everything is so screwed up.
Just because you can't understand something, it doesn't mean it's wrong.
They're experiencing the pain of whatever trauma has happened. They just are denying that it exists. Like a really unhealthy psychological denial trauma stage.
Yeah.
And they just haven't gone through the... Maybe we just need to figure out how to get them through the stages of grief.
It's a rough game. Anyone knows.
For the strong preyed upon the weak.
There are no rules. Anything goes.
Or like abuse, because I think the same thing happens with abuse, where like people who are in abusive relationships refuse to acknowledge it for a while. I mean, I guess it's the same with a lot of stuff. It's the same with like alcoholism, right? That's the first step of the 12-step program is admitting you have a problem. So it's like you have to get over the coping, whatever coping mechanism you have that allows you to ignore the problem because the problem doesn't just go away because you ignore it. And it's just this basic human psychology that they then inflict on the world. And it turns out it works just as well with a population as it does with an individual.
It's a battle of wits.
Yeah, absolutely. And it reminds me of Animal Farm, how the rules just slowly changed over
time. Right, right, piece by piece, yeah.
So it's like, at what point do you realize that something's terribly wrong?
The establishment wants a semi-lobotomized, quasi-retarded population.
The world is merely a tiny speck in the universe.
Universe? The world is round?
Yes, that's right. And it also goes around.
They don't want you thinking for yourself. They don't want you researching for yourself. They don't want you to be resourceful. They want you to take whatever it is they regurgitate to you, accept it as truth, and then move on, paint your body, and go to your favorite football team game.
If the boy goes about saying the world is round, he'll be so mixed up, he'll be wearing his shoes on his head.
Meanwhile, you're having everything stolen from you in the past, present, and future. But you're a semi-lobotomized, quasi-retarded member of the population, so you don't even know what's going on. You're essentially a dodo bird getting eaten up for sport.
Dude, if you haven't checked out Robot Polisher and his videos, man, this dude is like the top of the game. Please check out his material because he's helped wake a lot of people up, man, and his videos are legit.
Fucking take over this bitch, man. Because there's an opening right now. The doggies have been let off their leash for a little bit. And so now's the time to really get out some stuff. You can feel the snake is relaxed a little bit. Fucking bang, move, get more ground. Take back ground.
You are living between two planes now, somewhere between the ceiling and the floor.
Indoctrination blinded us all. From the very first day that we went to school, they put a globe in your face and that thing looked cool. The teacher explained how it all worked. Of course it sounded so berserk, but who was I to question it? Because I was just a tiny kid. It sounded crazy as could be, but teacher would never lie to me. She was real nice, she didn't know. She too was taught to believe in that globe. I don't blame her, it wasn't her fault. She was only repeating what she'd been taught. I went through life believing that lie. That spinning ball was now in my mind.
Don't let them take your mind.
Don't let them take your mind, man.
Don't let them tell you that you are not divine.
Don't let them do it, man. Take back control. Yeah.
Find the truth. Find it all.
Find it all, man. Yeah.
Don't believe their lies.
Don't believe it, man.
Let them take your mind.
Don't let them take your mind, man. Alright, man. Listen up. So I'm hurling through space on a road to nowhere. So I live my life without a care. Cause I was taught that there ain't no creator. That's what I was told from my educator. So I live my life so selfishly, there ain't gonna be no hell for me. I'll do what I want with no care for others, with no respect for my brothers. Until one day when I woke up and I drank some truth with my coffee cup. I learned that things ain't what they seem. This so-called reality is just a dream. There's deception everywhere that I look. The news, the TV, and in my school books. And I'm pretty soon I realize that everything's just a pack of lies, man.
Don't let them take your mind.
Don't let them take your mind, man.
Don't let them tell you that you are not divine.
Don't let them do it, man. Don't.
Take control.
On a biblical level, it's orchestrated by the devil. Many think that he don't exist, but that's what he wants, that's one of his tricks. But I found out that that dude's real, and I tell you, man, that's a bitter pill. So I questioned everything I was told. I had to question that spinning globe. I had to relearn it all again and get some truth inside this brain. And pretty soon I realized that the globe I was taught was a pack of lies. So I studied as hard as can be. I found the flat earth conspiracy. Man, it hit me like a ton of bricks. The globe I was taught was a devil's trick.
Don't let them take your mind.
Don't let them take your mind, man.
Don't let them tell you that you are not divine.
Take your mind, man. started to connect the dots, and I'm telling you, man, there are lots. I soon realized that the earth was flat. It's not a belief, man, it's a fact. And once I found out that reality, well, it did a funny thing to me. For a while there, I was pretty shocked, but now I know that there is a God. And once you get to that point of understanding, and once you know there ain't no moon landing, and once you know that space is fake, you view your life with a different take. It ain't just random chance that we're here. We ain't living on no stupid sphere. It ain't some ridiculous spinning ball. The earth is flat and God created it all.
Don't let them take your mind.
Don't let them take your mind, man.
Don't let them tell you that you are not divine.
Don't let them do it, man. No.
Take control.
About all these lies, I live a completely different life. I stopped reading the news and turned off the TV. That thing is evil as can be. I started being a nicer guy, and God forbid I tell a lie. I treat people with more respect, and I've got me a wife that I'd never neglect. Yeah, being good's working out for me. Now I ain't blinded and I can see. I know that there is a God above, and if I'm good, then he'll show me love. I try to live life selflessly to be the best that I can be. I treat people how I want to be treated since my indoctrination was defeated. So don't believe in the devil's lies, because it's God he wants to hide. That's why they teach that spinning ball, to make you think you ain't special at all. Don't believe what you're being told. Don't believe that you're evolved. It's all an accident and you are too. No, you're someone special and God made you.
Don't let them take your mind.
Don't let them take your mind, man.
Don't let them tell you that you are not divine.
Don't let them do it, no.
Take control of your soul.
You gotta take back control.
Find the truth.
Find the truth.
Find it all.
Find it all, man.
Don't believe their lies.
Don't believe it.
Let them take your mind.
Don't let them take your mind.
Flat Earth is certainly a very difficult truth to accept because the ramifications are so great. But we do indeed live on a flat and stationary Earth.